It's Super Tuesday, and Ohio's primary is a big part of it. We have live team coverage.
Kristen Severance is live in Toledo at Congresswoman Marcy Kaptur's campaign headquarters. Paul Kiska is in Cleveland, where there's a campaign rally for Congressman Dennis Kucinich. And Michael Baldwin has details on the race for Cuyahoga County prosecutor. Good evening, and thanks for joining us. I'm Lee Jordan.
And I'm Leon Bibb. Ohio, as we said, is a key state for Republican candidates running for president. And there are also a number of big local races tonight. We caught voters around town at polling locations casting their ballots. But one of the most talked about races in Northeast Ohio and Northwest Ohio is in the 9th Congressional District. That is where redistricting has pitted two favorite incumbents against each other, Democratic Congresswoman Marcy Kaptur and Democrat Congressman Dennis Kucinich. Both want the seat in a newly created Northern Ohio District. ONN's Kristen Severance joins us live from Toledo at Marcy Kaptur's headquarters. Kristen, what's the buzz there tonight?
I'm live at Marcy Kaptur's campaign headquarters in Toledo. I'm keeping a close eye on the 9th District congressional race. Now, to say this is a unique race, to say the least, pitting two Democratic incumbents against each other, incumbents and friends. Now, districts 9 and 10 merged together. After the last census, it created a large district along Lake Erie from Cleveland to Toledo. Ohio lost two U.S. House seats because of population declines, and a map drawn up by state legislators eliminated one Republican district and one Democratic district. Now, this merger pits two friends, Kaptur and Kucinich, against each other. An analysis by the Cook Political Report shows this new district will include 47% of Kaptur's old district compared to 39% of Kucinich's. The rest of District 9 would be new to both. And I sat down with Congresswoman Kaptur as she explains what this new area would consist of.
So the district actually extends from Toledo through Sandusky, through the city of Lorain, through Lakewood, and then to Point South, including the northern half of Parma. We have Brooklyn, Berea, Brook Park, and then wards 13 through 19 in Cleveland itself.
Now, Congressman Kucinich told me that this area is a staggering 120 miles long, so a very unique area. I also got off the phone with Kaptur's press chairman a little while ago. He told me she's feeling cautiously optimistic. Live in Toledo tonight, I'm Kristen Severance, The Ohio News Network.
Thanks, Kristen. So in just a few hours, either Marcy Kaptur or Dennis Kucinich will find out if they'll be without an Ohio-based seat in Congress next year. News Channel 5's Paul Kiska joins us from Cleveland on Lorain Avenue, where Dennis Kucinich is campaigning. Paul, what is the mood there?
Well, it's quiet right now, to be quite honestly. It usually is until the polls close after 7:30 tonight. Maybe then it'll start to pick up. But we are live from Ruben's Restaurant and Deli on Cleveland's west side near West 150th, one of Dennis Kucinich's favorite restaurants here in the city of Cleveland. He'll be coming here tonight. But for Dennis Kucinich to win it in the 9th, he's going to have to win it in Lorain. He's attending an event there, and he'll come here later on to Ruben's. Kucinich voted this morning at the Halloran Rec Center. Kucinich said in order to win against Marcy Kaptur, who retained a larger part of his district when the new 9th district was created, he'll need his Cleveland Lakewood base to turn out big time tonight, but he's also going to need to win Lorain, which now falls pretty much smack dab in the middle of this new 9th district along the lakeshore in Lorain. Kucinich's career in Congress after 15 years on the line tonight. Will he be celebrating or giving a concession speech from Rubens? We'll find out later on. Live from Cleveland's West Side, Paul Kiska, News Channel 5.
The race to replace outgoing Cuyahoga County Prosecutor Bill Mason is also on the ballot. Mason decided not to run for re-election, and a slew of candidates want his job. News Channel 5's Michael Baldwin joins us in the newsroom. And Michael, we have some familiar faces and some new ones.
We do, Lee, and we have five candidates on the Democratic side that would love to represent the county. A little icing on the cake for whoever wins the primary. There was no Republican in the race, so the winner here was virtually assured the job.
The five candidates running in the Democratic primary include former Judge Tim McGinty. He wants to install a central booking system and have prosecutors work round the clock to decide which charges to pursue. Robert Triazzi, the former Cleveland law director, he wants to have more specialized teams like a sex crimes unit. James McDonald, a former assistant prosecutor, promises to save taxpayers a ton of money by a huge reduction in capital murder indictments. Former Cleveland law director Subodh Chandra wants to form a conviction integrity unit and look into cases where people may have been wrongly convicted. Finally, Stephanie Hall is a former Cleveland police officer. She wants to form a citizens review board to make the office more responsive to the people.
Now the question is, which plan do voters want? We'll find out later tonight. Live in the newsroom, Michael Baldwin, News Channel 5.
Thank you, Michael. Voters in 10 states are heading to the polls today to make their choices in the Republican presidential race. Mitt Romney has the momentum. He is fresh off victories in Arizona and Michigan 1 week ago and in Washington State Saturday. But Rick Santorum, who has not had a win for nearly a month, believes he has a fighting chance in one of tonight's most important contests, Ohio. Newt Gingrich is counting on a win in his home state of Georgia, and Ron Paul is campaigning in Idaho. When the results of today's election come in, turn to News Channel 5. We will scroll election results on the bottom of your screen. Plus, log on to NewsNet5.com for a live election webcast starting at 9 o'clock. Then on News Channel 5 at 11 o'clock, we're going to bring you up to date on where the races stand.